Who am I? Why am I here? When I'm done rolling up this booger, should I eat it or throw it out the window? Feels good.
Dedicated to all the doubtful souls. If you are one. If you're not, then it's not dedicated. So don't take it offense. You can be very strong without any doubts in your life. But I doubt it. Because I can feel. What does it mean to you being doubtful? Not only that choosing this shirt or that shirt. It's when you are not sure why you're here on the earth. Jump ahead, I will actually read you my title for today. The sands of time are it came up last night in a beautiful conversation. Fingers and your thumb. And it goes like this. How to stop being annoying to yourself. For the miracle. For the miracle. A lot. Bing, 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 bing. No, I'm not annoying to myself. I'm not the one who doubts, I know. What do you know? I don't know anything. So how do you know? Yeah, baby, let's get married. Maybe you know, so you tell me. We've been alone too long. But you have to tell me. You cannot just sit let's and wait that something happened and then complain when it's not happened or it doesn't happen let's the way you want. We're that strong. So you tell me. You put your comments down. Yeah, let's do something crazy. You put your view down. Something absolutely wrong. Only then becomes an active way of creation. Only then. If you keep it in your mind, you're perpetuating the same old doubt non-stop. And this is what's annoying you. This is what's annoying most of the people. They're wishing for something. They're asking for something better in their life, better for others, better for humanity. But they don't state it anywhere out loud. In writing, in speeches, in videos, in a house conversations, with your actions. If you're sitting at home waiting for the rain to stop, and then you will go wherever you have to go, you're getting angry because rain is falling. Or you're going to miss your appointment or whatever you have. Whose fault is it? You can't complain. Or rain? I mean, if you're blaming rain, you're blaming God. If you're blaming God, you're blaming yourself again. So, I mean, it's... So you rather just make a decision. Okay, I'll go when the rain stops, or I'll go right now. When you get angry, who is the one who is creating this anger? When you're getting judgmental, who is the one who creates this judgment from within? Same applies for when you love somebody. When you care for somebody, when you're compassionate to somebody, who's the one who creates this frequency, this vibration? It's always you. Same thing with doubt, same thing with being annoying to yourself. Because you're always expecting something will happen and 60 years later, life is gone. Question is now how to stop being annoying to yourself. You go with the small steps, small, very tiny little steps, baby steps. First, recognize that you are the one who is doing this to yourself. The light came through the window. Not the other way around. Not other driver passing by, cutting you off, not the political parties, you know, left and right, they are doing their, you know, punch work. Doesn't matter. They're just there, a scenery for you to realize that you're the one who can actually stop being upset with this. Rather make fun. I mean, make fun of Democrats, liberals, whatever, they are in a different countries. All you have a left and right, but nobody has a heart. You're sitting in the middle, left and right, and then what? There was a joke, kiddie joke. My son told me some time ago. A mouse is always sneaking out in the middle of the night and eating everything through the house. Okay, so the way how they want to trick him and to catch this mouse, they say, okay, we'll put this time very close to his little hole, cheese on one side and ham on the other side. And he was very, you know, mouse was quite, you know, eating everything, can eat anything. But this time, when he comes out of the hole, busy in the go sunlight. Left, oh cheese, oh ham, oh cheese, which one? Cheese, ham, cheese, ham, the cheese, ham. In all this doubt of his, the owner of the house just dropped a brick on his head. So he catch him, or whatever, killed him. So the point of the story is, the doubt could kill you. So, he made it better, so anyway. It just kind of came to me that I share this with you. It's very important to recognize when you're doubting, because you can just save so much trouble for your well-being. It's incredible. You will transmit so much energy when you just becoming you. When you know. When you know that even being doubtful is not wrong. But recognizing that you are doubtful is absolutely beautiful. It's fucking beautiful if you can say to yourself, yes, I was doubtful. Why am I doing this to myself?
The nameless.
Because you're becoming a better person. Every time you recognize little slices of your negative behavior, of your doubtful behavior, of your aggressive behavior, you're becoming a better person. And it's happening so fast now, because we have a million different opportunities a day. Doesn't matter, war, refugees, a famine, earthquakes, whatever. These are opportunities for you that you becoming better person, because earthquake happens. What is your first initial feeling about, oh, fear? Hopefully it's not coming to hit us here. Maybe. Most of the people. The next one is, oh, you suddenly have a compassion in your heart and say, wow, I would like to help these people. And then you have the politicians, oh, we cannot take the refugees. We have only enough food for, you know, 37 billion people. So they don't want to share with anybody. Oh, these are greedy bastards. So by this kind of just approach, you're becoming actually the one who's cleansing yourself, because you don't need anybody else to heal you, to you know, bring you all the beautiful energies are there. You just have to way to channel them through you, so you can absolutely recognize who you are. And this is where this reconnection with Creator actually increasing. This is what many of these new agers are talking. The whale is thinning. No, this is the whale about who you really are. This is like a fog in your head.
You got me.
Gets cleared. The fog is not around you.
Even though
or
the news
somebody
is
else
bad.
Put it like a screen over the all the planet, and nobody can see outside, nobody can see inside.
You got me singing. Ever since
the fog is in your head.
You got me thinking.
Let's work on your fog so you can start singing. And I absolutely see
you got me singing.
Future. I see fucking beautiful tomorrow. This is so incredible. What we seen though will do to you, it'll kick you in your ass that you will be absolutely funny laughing at yourself flying so high up.
You got me singing.
Then question yourself, I could do this earlier. Doesn't matter. You do it now. When you hear this, you do it now. Accept that you're a better person. First of all, you're watching these things. Okay. You're already a much better person than before you start watching. This is why I'm here, to make fun of you, to make fun of myself, basically to help all the humanity to get
together.
Because if we're keeping separateness
in a jail
as our primary
goal,
This is where doubt is. It always gives you choices. And it's always put you in the blame if you choose A versus B or left versus right. I'm telling you, this is absolutely, you know, weird. Doesn't matter, you choose left, okay. Doesn't matter, you choose right, it is okay. I mean, from perspective of observer. So what, you can be Democrat, okay, you can be liberal, okay. You can be just in the middle, this is okay, from the observer point. But from the actual one who actually experiencing it, he can always be easily put in the blame. If he doesn't realize, okay, doesn't matter. I can be in the morning liberal, in the afternoon conservative. I can be gay in the evening, I can be transvestite in the morning. Is it? Okay, so it's not opposite. But anyway, you can have multiple choices. You don't have to be two choices. Consider when you're noticing that you're doubtful. This is important. When you're noticing that you're doubtful, you becoming a better person.
Ciao. Can I ever repay you?
Well, the reward would be good. There is some damage to my car. It's a high-performance machine, so I had to fill it with premium.
You a la 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 long, a la 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 long, 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 come on. Running wild.